إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek the help only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide Him, and whomever misguide, no one will guide him. I witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. We're still in the series of the Sahaba, lives of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we are still talking about the story of Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. May Allah please with this amazing sahabi radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. This sahabi Abdul Rahman bin Auf, one of the best sahaba radiyallahu anhu, he is among of the sahaba which Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guarantee the paradise for them. The 10 sahaba mentioned in one hadith that the jannah is guarantee for them, glad tidings for them, the Jannah, Abdul Rahman bin Auf. And today we continue some of the event happen and occur with Abdul Rahman bin Auf radiyallahu an. In the Battle of Badr, and he was in the first line in the battlefield. Abdul Rahman bin Auf radiyallahu anhu said, "Inni lawaqifun yawma badrin fi as-saf." He was standing in the line in the Battle of Badr. He looked at his right and he looked at in his left. He found two young men from the Al-Ansar, from the supporter, from Al-Ansar. And they were very young. And subhanallah, one of them, he said, "Oh uncle," he talking to Abdul Rahman bin Auf, "do you know Abu Jahl?" He said, "Yes." He said, what you asking about him? Why you ask about Abu Jahl? What do you want from him?" He said, the young man, I just heard, he cursed Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Young man, he came to the Battle of Badr and he saw Abdul Rahman bin Auf and he spoke to, oh uncle, "Do you know Abu Jahl?" He said, "Yes, I know. What do you want from him?" He said, "I heard he cursed Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." And he said, "والذي نفسي بيده," by the one my soul in his hand, referred to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. "If I saw him, I will not leave him until I kill him or he kill me." Young man, 15 years old, facing the leader of the mushrikeen, Abu Jahl, the most enemy person, the enemy of Islam. We call him the Pharaoh of the Ummah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Abdul Rahman bin Auf, he shocked, what he is talking, young man, he going to face that person, evil, strong, he has army. Then the person is in his left hand. He said, "Oh uncle, do you know Abu Jahl?" He said, "What do you want from him?" He said, "I heard that he cursed Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." He spoke the same word from the young man in his right hand. They were brother, twins. And both of them, they want to compete who will kill Abu Jahl. Because they just hear that Abu Jahl cursed Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Abdul Rahman bin Auf, when he saw Abu Jahl, big person, riding the horse, He said, this is what you are looking for. Then the both of them, their name were Mu'adh wa Mu'awwadh ibn al-Afra. Mu'adh wa Mu'awwadh ibn al-Afra. When Abdurrahman ibn Auf point to the Abu Jahl in the Battle of Badr, they speed up and both of them, they stab him with the sword. And they straight away went to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I killed Abu Jahl. And the other brother, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I am the one killed Abu Jahl. Then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, did you clean your sword? They said, no. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam looked to the sword and he said, both of you killed him. Subhanallah. Kilakuma qatala. And here we learn amazing understanding the love to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This young man, young men, just here, they never saw Abu Jahl. Just they heard that Abu Jahl, he is the enemy of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and he kills him. That give him a subhanAllah feeling they want to defend Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and revenge for the name of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Who narrated that hadith? Abdurrahman bin Auf, and he was among of the people who attend the Battle of Badr. And as we spoke last lecture, Abdurrahman bin Auf did not miss any battlefield. He attended all the battlefield. Abdurrahman bin Auf radiyallahu anhu. Another story for the great Sahabi Abdurrahman bin Auf. Abdullah bin Abbas, Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu anhu, he went to Al-Sham. Al-Sham, what is mean Al-Sham? Al-Sham, it's a country, they call it Middle East nowadays. It's combined between Syria and Lebanon and Jordan and Palestine. In that time, they call it Bilad al-Sham. So Umar bin Khattab, he went to the Al-Sham, to Bilad al-Sham, to the Middle East. When he arrived to one valley after Al-Hijaz, after he crossed north of Medina, they call Bilad al-Hijaz. People saw him and met Umar bin Khattab and they told him, Subhanallah, there is, wal-iyadhu billah, disease spread around in Al-Sham. Subhanallah, and that disease spread around. People had, whomever have this disease, he died. And you know, from the Sahaba radiallahu anh, almost 18,000 buried, 18,000 buried in Jordan and in that area, the most of them, they die with this disease. And subhanAllah, you found most of the Sahaba, okay, they buried not in their hometown in Medina. They went for spreading da'wah. And this is also a lesson for us that we should strive and struggle to spread the da'wah of Islam. Then Ibn Abbas said, Umar al-Khattab, said, please call Al-Muhajirin Al-Ansar, the migrator who migrated to Medina. They call him Al-Muhajirin, and who become a Muslim in Medina, they call them Al-Ansar, the supporter. So then Umar al-Khattab asked them as a shura. Shura mean ask their opinion. What we should do? Shall we continue our trip or we step back? Then subhanAllah, some of them, they said, we're thinking we continue because we went for one purpose, we have to fulfill that purpose. Another group, they said, oh Umar bin Khattab, don't go, don't continue because there is a disease, we should not go there. Then subhanallah, Umar bin Khattab keep asking question, and the people divided to two opinion. Then Umar bin Khattab asked the Al-Ansar and they say same. And they said same. ثم قال ادعوا لي من كان هنا من مشيخة قريش من مهاجرة الفتح فدعوهم فلم يختلف عليه فرجلان فقالوا نرى أن ترجع بالناس ولا تقدمهم على هذا الوباء. Then Umar bin Khattab asked the ulama, the scholars of the people of al-Muhajirin. And all of them, they have one opinion that we should not continue the trip. Go back. And subhanallah, Umar al-Khattab, he followed that opinion. Then Abu Ubaidah al-Jarrah, he said, Ya Umar al-Khattab, are you running away from the qadr, from the destiny of Allah, from the qadr of Allah? Then Umar al-Khattab, he said, he looked at Abu Ubaidah al-Jarrah, he said, I wish that someone else said that, not you, O Abu Ubaidah. And he said, we run from the qadarullah to the qadarullah. We run away from the one destiny to the other destiny. Subhanallah. And here it's amazing statement from Umar al-Khattab. He said, and he gave him an example. If you have a camel and you have two lands, one greeny, one no grass, which you choose for you camel to eat, the greeny one or the dried one? If you take it to the greeny, this is by the qadar of Allah. And if you take it to the drought, also this is by qadar Allah. Then subhanAllah, Abu Ubaidah understood the lesson. Then who gave the final answer? Here the point of the story. Okay, here the point of story. Abdurrahman bin Auf, the great Sahabi. He said he wasn't attend that meeting. When he arrived, he said, Inna indi min hadha ilma. Indeed, I have knowledge about this matter. Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I heard the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqulu, Idha sami'tum bi ardin fala taqdumu alayhi, wa idha waqa'a bi ardin wa antum biha فلا تخرجوا فرارا منه فحمد الله عمر ثم انصرف. This hadith that I heard the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, if you hear that disease, they call الطاعون, one kind of disease spread around, if you hear that in one land, don't come in, and if that happen while you are inside the land, don't go out. Look at the hadith. If you hear that disease in one land, don't come in, and don't, if that disease happen while you are inside the land, don't come out. فَلَا تَخْرُجُوا مِنْ فِرَارَ مِنْ, and don't run away from that disease if you are in the land which that disease occur. Then Umar bin Khattab, he thanks Allah and حَمِدَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ صَرَ, then he go. So subhanAllah, Umar bin Khattab رضي الله عنه, he give solution for the Sahaba in big decision, something like that. Another moment or event for Abdurrahman bin Auf mentioned in the history. How Abdurrahman bin Auf, he was very generous and very gentle, and he gave in the path of Allah so much donation, so much sadaqah. وعن أبي سلمة أن عبد الرحمن بن عوف أوصى بحديقة لأمهات المؤمنين بيعت بأربعمائة ألف. الله أكبر. عبد الرحمن بن عوف, how much that person gentle to the mothers of the believer, the wives of الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. What he did, he give وصية, he give سبحان الله an order for one garden. This garden only to the mothers of the believers, ummahatul mu'minin, wives of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That garden sold with the price 400,000. 400,000. And this hadith narrate in Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi, hadith number 3750. And Imam al-Albani, he said this hadith, hadithun hasanun sahih, authentic. Subhanallah. 400,000, he give donation for the mothers of believers. How much that person is very generous to the mothers of believers, subhanAllah, to the wives of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وعن أمي بكر أن عبد الرحمن بن عوف باع أرضا له من عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه بأربعين ألف دينار فقسم في فقراء بني زهرة وفي ذي الحاجة من الناس وفي أمهات المؤمنين. Subhanallah. This another narration that Abdurrahman bin Auf sold a land, subhanallah, with 40,000 dinars, not dirham, dinars, like that currency is very big. And he divide that land, okay, he donate to the poor of for the poor people from the tribes of Bani Zuhra, and for the needy one, and for the mothers of the believers, Ummahatul Mu'mineen, radiyallahu anhum wa radu an. Let's go to the third category, talking about the life of Abdurrahman bin Auf. His advices. Abdurrahman bin Auf, he advised so much. So let's stop a moment for some of the advice he shared with us. Radiyallahu anhu. May Allah please with Abdurrahman bin Auf. كان عبد الرحمن بن عوف مع كثرة ماله وإنفاقه في سبيل الله يحاسب نفسه دائما. يعني even عبد الرحمن بن عوف, he was very rich, he has a lots of money, he's very, very wealthy, he still accounting himself, he still exam himself, test himself, how's his iman. And he said, عبد الرحمن بن عوف, ابتلينا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بالضراء فصبرنا ثم ابتلينا بالسراء بعده فلم نصبر. سبحان الله, he's testing himself and he's blaming himself. He said, in the time of Rasul Salam, Allah test us with a hardship, with a hardship, poorness and hardship. We were patient. ثم ابتلينا, then Allah test us with the sarra, with the nice life, with a good life, with the wealthy, with the money, and we are not really patient. He's blaming himself, he's regretting. But in the fact, no, he was giving donation, he was very good, but him still blaming himself. And look at himself, he did not do much, he did not do much. And this is the sign of the al-iman. The true believer, brothers and sisters, the person who always tests himself and always blaming himself. If you ask me, Muaz, what are you talking about, Ustaz Muaz? I will say, look at the Quran. قال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة. Allah swear by the day of judgment, and Allah swear by the soul which is blaming himself or blame herself. نفس اللوامة, تلوم, always blaming, whatever. I didn't do much, I didn't repent to Allah, I fall in sin, always blaming, always in fighting inside this, himself to do better. This is a sign of believer. And there is another saying, they said, the true believer, he saw his sin as a mountain over his head. He's so much worried that the mountain fall over him. And the munafiq, the hypocrite, he always look at his sin as a fly came to his food and push away without any feeling or regretting about what he's doing. He's not really aware about in accounting himself in the account, tobili, subhanAllah, account himself, testing himself, repent. When he make a small error or small mistake, he look at as a big mistake, and he always repent and ask forgiveness from that error, the one he fall in. This is one of the advice for Abdurrahman Auf. Al-insan yubtala fi hadhi dunya. The person, Allah test him, sometimes with a hardship, sometimes with the easy ship, sometimes with the wealthy, sometimes with the money. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test Sulaiman alayhi salam, Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam, with the big ni'mah, with wealth, the wind under his commandments, the jinn under his commandments. He understanding the language of the animals, and he being given palace and castles, subhanallah. And he was thankful to Allah. Allah says, ni'ma al-abdu. Allah praised Sulaiman alayhi salam because he was a great servant. He were thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah tests the Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam with the disease and hardship for more than 18 years in diseases. And subhanAllah, until everybody running away from him with that so much pain, disease in his skin. And Allah praised him and he said, Ni'ma al-Abdu. The same word Allah used for Sulaiman, Ni'ma al-Abdu, Allah used when he mentioned the story of Ayyub alayhi salam. Ni'ma al-Abdu innahu awwab. This praising to that servant, Ni'ma al-Abd, al-Abd, the servant, Ni'ma, this is very good servants, subhanAllah. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَلَيْسَ ذَٰلِكَ لِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ. عَجَبًا, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam amazed, so much amazing for the believer. If all his things is good, whatever happened to him is good. If something goodness happened to him, he will be thankful and he will be rewarded and he will be a good for him. And if Allah tests him with a hardship or calamity, he will be a patient and he will be rewarded for it, and that will be a goodness for him. Subha khair, good for the believer. So the believer always winning in all cases, in the hardship or easy ship, or in the hard test or easy test, in wealthy test or in poorness. Whatever the test is, the believer, the true believer, always winning and always get reward. Subhanallah. This is only for the believers. Look at the people who does not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever Allah provide to them, if a small test happened to him, he start cursing. He start unthankful. He said, oh God, you did this to me. You did this to me. And he keep complaining. And he forget, subhanAllah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him only in test and trial to see who really a true believer or not true believer. One time also Abdurrahman bin Auf, they brought up to him food, very tasty food. And he were fasting. صَائِمًا وَكَانَ صَائِمًا. And he were fasting. He said, and he started crying. He said, قُتِلَ مُصْعَبُ بْنُ عُمَيْرُ وَكَانَ خَيْرًا مِنِّي. مُصْعَبُ بْنُ عُمَيْرُ, one of the great Sahaba. He said, he been killed, he been martyr, he been shaheed. And he were better than me. فَلَمْ يُوجَدْ لَهُ مَا يُكَفَّنُ فِيهِ إِلَّا بُرْدَ. They could not find anything to cover him. When he, subhanAllah, when the Sahaba went to bury him, they could not find any sheet can cover all his body. And subhanAllah, now we have the easy life. We have a food, we have. لَقَدْ خَشِيتُ أَن تَكُونَ قَدْ عُجِّلَتْ لَنَا طَيِّبَاتُنَا فِي حَدَيَاتِنَا الدُّنْيَا. And he stared, I'm so worried that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the enjoyable time only in dunya, and in akhirah we don't have much. And he started crying and he pushed away the food. He said, take the food, remove the food from me. Subhanallah. He said, Mus'ab bin Umayr, he was better than me. And when they buried nothing for him to cover, only one sheet, not even can cover all his body. If they cover his head, his foot can show. If they cover his foot, his head can show. Subhanallah. And Mus'ab bin Umayr, before Islam, he was among of the most wealthy person in Mecca. Even they said, if he passed from this way, the women knew that Mus'ab bin Umayr, he passed from this road or from this way, because he used to have unique perfume, very expensive perfume. His mother used to buy from Syria and from other countries. Subhanallah. When he became Muslim, he left all the dunya and he migrate to, subhanallah, migrate in the path of Allah, fi sabilillah, to Medina. And he accept the hard and tough life for Allah's sake. Subhanallah. So this is advice for wealthy. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with money, with wealth, be careful that enjoyable only that came to you for enjoy, for you to, for temporary enjoyment, and you will lose the akhirah. Be the thankful. Fear Allah in the money, the one Allah give to you. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and give and donate and give sadaqah for the fuqara and masakeen, and know the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you upon that money. So you will be like the Abdurrahman bin Auf. The money were in his hand, not in his inside his heart. وَكَانُ يَقُولُونَ بِهِ كَذَا وَهَكَذَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And they used to say, this money in the path of Allah, in this way and this way and this way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among of the people who loved Sahabatul Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who loved the companion of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom follow the way of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test them in the easy ship and hardship, and always they win, and they will be patient and they will be thankful. If you analyze the Quran, so many verses advising us about as-sabr wa shukr, as-sabr wa shukr, and both of the words start with the as-sabr wa shukr, and this word as-sabr, patient, and shukr is thankful. Qala ta'ala wa qaleelun min ibadi ash-shakur. Few number of the people who is really thankful. Qaleel, few, small number, a little number of the people. Wa qaleelun min ibadiya, from my servants, just few among of my servants thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa qaleelun min ibadiya ash-shakur, just a small number, few number of people, they are really thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Asr, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wal 'asr. Innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa 'amilus salihat wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. Allah swear by the time Al-Asr, innal insana lafi khusr, indeed the person, the human being, will be a loser except who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he do good deeds, عَمِلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. Advise one another by al-haq, by the truth, and advise one another by as-sabr, by patience. Look how much patience is important. The ulama says four things every single Muslim should know. Four things. First of all, al-ilm, the knowledge. Qala ta'ala, fa'alam annahu la ilaha illallah. No, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowledge. Seek the knowledge. Know Allah. Know His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Know the Book of Allah, Al-Quran. Know your way of life, Islam. You should know. Seeking knowledge is very important. And the second things every single Muslim should know and understand after knowledge, Al-Amal. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Al-amal, doing the action, doing the good deeds. You analyze the Quran in many, 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 many verses. Allah says, amanu wa amilu salihat. Allah combined the iman, the faith, with the good deeds, with the righteous deeds, with the good action. So knowledge without amal, it's not going to work. And amal without knowledge is not going to work. So always al-ilm wal-amal. Know the knowledge, al-ilm, and the amal, the good deeds. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. And then, after knowing and doing good deeds, we should da'wah to ila sabilillah. We should do the da'wah for the knowledge we learn. And the last one, as-sabr wa ala al-adha. Be patient in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, if you analyze the advices of Luqman alayhi salam, Luqman al-Hakim radiyallahu anhu aw alayhi salam, one of the great person, Allah named one surah by his name, Luqman, and he were very wise person, very wise person, Al-Hakim, Luqman al-Hakim. He said to his son, Ya Bunayya, Aqim al-Salata, Wa'mur bil-Ma'rufi, Wanha anil munkar, Wasbir ala ma asaba. Oh my son, oh my son, advise his son, Ya Bunayya, Aqim al-Salata, perform the Salat, Aqim al-Salata, Wa'mur bil-Ma'ruf, an order, an advice, and spread al-Ma'ruf, the goodness. Order the people to do good. Give da'wah for the people. Wanha anil munkar, and avoid, and advise the people to avoid al-munkar, al-haram, the evil act, the bad deeds. Wasbir, hear the what we want from the ayah. Wasbir ala ma asabak. Be patient from what Allah tests you. So if you want to do amrun bil ma'ruf wa nahya al munkar, if you want to do da'wah, you should have a patient. You should be patient. Sabr is very important. Amna Abdurrahman bin Auf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test him, and he were patient in the early age. And we all know the story that after Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam make him a brotherhood with Sa'id ibn Rabi', Sa'd ibn Rabi' from the Al-Ansar, and he make him a brother with Abdurrahman bin Auf. And Abdurrahman bin Auf, subhanallah, after he talked to him, Sa'd ibn Rabi', he said, listen, my brother, you are my brother in Islam. People in Al-Madina, in Yathrib, they were well known that I am among of the most wealthy person, among of the most wealthy people in Medina. Look at my money. I will divide two parts, half for you and half for me. And I have two wives. Look at both of them and choose whomever you like. I will divorce. Then after her iddah, you can marry her. Look at what kind of brotherhood. Subhanallah, love each other for sake of Allah. And Abdurrahman bin Auf, he said, Barakallahu laka fi ahlika wa malik. May Allah bless you in your wealth and in your family. Guide me to the shopping center. Guide me to the trading place. I would like to work using my hand. Subhanallah, Abdurrahman bin Auf, he went for working and trading until he become the most wealthy Sahabi radiyallahu anhu. They said, we used to be amazed how many caravan come from different countries. All the caravan belonged to Abdurrahman bin Auf, from Syria, from Yemen, from Egypt. Subhanallah. And this is a lesson. So Abdurrahman bin Auf, even he was very big businessman, very wealthy, He did not forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He continued thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He continued giving in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is the great Sahabi Abdurrahman bin Auf. Amazing picture for our life to take advantage and take lessons, subhanallah, for ourselves to be all in our life, always give without fear, without subhanAllah stinginess. Some people, they have so much money, when they give in the path of Allah, they worried that money, their money will be decreased, and they forget the hadith of Rasul, authentic hadith. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, peace be upon him, ما نقص مال من صدقة. The money will not decrease from the صدقة, from donation. So inshallah, this is, even if you can donate in 1 ringgit, 2 ringgit, or $1, or one dinar, one dirham, don't hesitate or don't be and be among of the miser or stingy. Be generous, because this money is not your money, brother and sister. This is money belong to Allah. Allah giving you, and give that money for you to use in the good way. So this is, inshallah, just final advice shared with you about the story of Abdurrahman bin Auf radiyallahu an. May Allah gather us with this sahabi in Jannah. Ameen, ameen. And inshallah, next week we start with the new story with the great of the companions radiyallahu anhum. May Allah please with them by the story of the Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas radiyallahu anhu. Great sahabi. Inshallah, you will be hearing and listening, if Allah give us life, about that sahabi from the 10 of the sahaba that Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guarantee for them the Jannah and glad tidings for them the paradise. May Allah gather us with them in Jannah. Ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tasliman kathira. You have any question about Abdurrahman bin Auf radiallahu anhu, or any other question like to share? Jazakumullah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.